Time for Law and Disorder.
I demand a lawyer.
With attorney Jeff Kaufman on 101.1 WJRR.
All right, we welcome in Jeff Kaufman from Kaufman & Lynn. Fine local firm here that, you know, if you find yourself injured because of slip and fall, car accident, something else, and you're looking, I need some guidance, I need some help, I need some direction to be put in.
Jeff's your man. If he can't do it, no one can. Very easy to get in touch with. Jeff@whenyouneedus.com. You can use that if you want. Or #546 on your cell. You look like a gentleman who went to a nice, smooth concert last night.
Maybe a Richard Marx show.
Hey, I was taking one for the team. Stop it.
Wow, you took two for the team on that
one. Listen, that's what a good person does.
Uh-huh.
You know, we suffer quietly. You know, even if I was the only dude it was bad.
Can I ask you on that note?
Go ahead.
I'm just venturing a guess here. If you are a dude who's, you know, maybe looking for some romance and you're free as a bird, that might have been a good place to go trolling.
Yeah, if you were the Golden Bachelor, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, dude.
I mean, I hear you. I'm just wondering where I get one of these t-shirts. I've been a sponsor for like how many stupid amount of years?
One of what t-shirts?
What t-shirt?
The one we're wearing right now. That's
this
pretty cool.
Thing,
yeah.
This is about 8 years old.
They need to bring those back. Those look good.
It's the AC/DC JRR letters.
Mm-hmm. Those look real good.
Well, I'm just wearing a shirt that says California Republic on it.
Well, not that one.
We got some questions. We got some questions for you, Kaufman.
Sure, let's do this.
Everybody wants a t-shirt, Taco.
Yep.
That one. That one.
Remember, 22526 with your personal injury questions. And when you send them in, please keep them short. Okay. Does a living will override a divorce where the partner gets half of the assets?
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course it does. You know, living will, unless you paid a certain amount of money for it. For example, you made a certain agreement and... But here's the thing. When you get divorced, the judge goes, all right, here's the way this all works. I'm going to do this, 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 and this. And when the divorce breaks this up, you know, a will can be rewritten at any time they want to. For example, you can redo a will. You write one today and, you know, blow it up tomorrow.
But usually that will is done with the wife and the husband.
Of course it is. Both of them, but they can say, hey, listen, I'm changing. We're getting divorced. You're no longer getting half my money.
But doesn't the other one have to be there for the rewriting of it? Really?
No, not at all.
So I could go in and switch mine around and then...
Well, I don't tell Miss Taco I gave you this advice, okay?
But yes is the answer.
Yes, you could. But she can still say she's entitled to a certain amount as your wife, which is, I believe, a third... If you have kids and stuff like that.
A third of nothing's nothing, I mean.
Well, yeah.
Question for Jeff.
Blood from a stone, right?
That's it. I think I might have like a Richard Marx CD laying around. Who can we contact about medical bills? My wife had our son in 2022. She met her max out of pocket for that year. Then, over a year later, she started getting bills from the hospital for back in 2022. But she was getting them in 23.
Remember Pauly Shore as the Weezer? As
the Weasel. Yeah.
You know, he used to go, scumbags. I can't even do it. You know what I'm talking about.
Oh, I know exactly.
But they're terrible, man. You know, those hospitals, they'll come after you. Yeah, we had this bill from 1922. Yeah, they're just not good.
So what do they do?
What's the answer?
Notify your insurance company. Go to your insurance company and say, listen, this was supposed to be paid. That's what you have to do. You follow up with your insurance company.
Tell them exactly what you just typed into us. Look.
Yeah, don't do the Pauly Shore scumbag thing.
No.
Avoid that.
No, that was a Kaufman thing.
You guys ever know insurance? That's one of those things that... When you do decide to dive in and start asking some questions, 9 times out of 10, you're either
screwed
or more confused and or angry than before you even place the call.
No, a lot of times they might bail. They don't want to deal with it. They were taking a shot. You know, that's what they do. They have all, you know, the $300 Band-Aids and stuff like that. That actually happens.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I know. Is there a general settlement formula used for medical settlements due to a car accident?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, what happens is the insurance companies have algorithms, which means they said, okay, let's say you had $50,000 in medicals, and they said, well, we're only going to pay this much of that or a multiplier of that and include that your future medicals and stuff in there. So, yeah, they try to use a multiplier against you, and depending on the law firm, some people get more and some people get less.
Okay. If a coworker's fired because of an inappropriate statement that was made at an after-hours event, other than right to work state, is it fair to fire him if he was served alcohol? Event was optional, but drinking was encouraged.
See, did you hold on? Did you see what they said there? Barring the right to work state. Okay, well, you're in a right to work state. You can't just say, well, that doesn't count because we're not in one. You are in one. Maybe a state that isn't, you know, you might have a different argument. But if you're in Florida, you know, it's a right to work state.
So basically, don't go to the company party.
And don't say stupid stuff. I'm sure you're a good guy, but you know what? I promise you this. This ain't the first time you had a little too much to drink and you said some stupid stuff.
You know
the people who do it. I know friends of mine. The minute they get a drink in them, they start saying some interesting things. You know, if you're one of those people, you got to say no.
Yeah, they get them liquor lips.
Oh.
Like, just the liquor just touches the lips.
I'm not normally political, but...
It's the ultimate truth serum.
We know a couple.
You're Catholic. You know who knows what will come out of your mouth when you've been drinking.
Pat, the ones that... One beer and all of a sudden you're like, whoa, what happened? Yeah. That got weird.
Email balls, that's what you get.
Jeff, is it possible and hard to sue for false accusation of sexual harassment at work?
Well, here's the problem. You're trying to go after somebody who you're going to have to get a judgment against them. And this isn't like a personal injury case where somebody's going to take your case for, let's just say, money afterwards, what they call a contingency fee. Because an attorney knows, wait a minute, I'm going after somebody who might not have any money. And that's a lot of time and effort. And one of the arguments they make is the truth. So let's say something you didn't consider sexual harassment, like our buddy who went to the party and got, you know, a little too much liquor on, and you made a comment. If a jury goes, yeah, I can see that, you know, that's the big problem, because you're going to have to put all your money to pay for the attorney. And if something comes out afterwards, good for you. But if not, it's expensive, man. You might want to walk that one off.
Yeah, you're taking one of the shorts. My mother passed away 2 years. Sorry to hear that. Mother passed away 2 years ago without a will. What can I do to be able to collect what she had in the bank and safety deposit box?
Well, you have to set up an estate. So you're going to have to hire an estate attorney, and that attorney is going to have to get everything moving for you. And then the judge will, after it's done, the judge will make determinations, and then that order will go to the bank.
Didn't you say if there's money in a bank account, you know
right
somebody?
Right to survivorship.
But
that's what you have to do.
You know somebody who can do it, but a lawyer, but it'll cost you like several thousand dollars.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's $3,000 just to set up, just to start it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's expensive.
Well, that stinks if it's just like $4,000 in the bank. You're like,
yeah. It might not be worth it.
I need a lawyer for breach of contract.
A business lawyer. Okay.
Breach of contract, and then it says $1.4 million in damages.
$1.4 million in damages. Okay. Now you got to be able to collect that. So the hard thing is there are some law firms that will do that, but, you know, breach of contract is pretty clear, and you have a specific period of time to do that. So you're going to have to get on that as soon as possible. If you want, give us a call, and hopefully we can put you in the right direction.
Jeff@whenyouneedus.com is his direct email. Again, that's Jeff@whenyouneedus.com or #546 on your cell. That's the cool thing about Jeff, and we remind you every now and then, the first thing he's going to tell you is if you even need a lawyer, because sometimes you don't, and he doesn't want you wasting your money on it.
Yeah, but I have a feeling for $1.4 million, if that's actual,
you're going to need a lawyer. Yeah, I'd imagine. How long are workman's comp claims good for?
Ooh, tough call. Depends on when it happened. I mean, my advice is that if it happened more than 2-3 years ago, definitely contact a lawyer now. There are a lot of great workers' comp attorneys out there that I can put you in touch with. But if you waited, you know, 5, 6, 7 years, you know, that's normally a dead zone.
Okay, Jeff@whenyouneedus.com. The front desk of my husband's doctor's office refused to fill his medications, even though the doctor signed the prescription. He's now on day 3, and this was last week. So now he'd be on day 10. Now on day 3 without his highly dependent meds. Suggestions?
Suggestion is you call your doctor. It's his office. I don't understand how his front of his office isn't doing the prescription. Normally, a doctor gives you a prescription and you go out and get it filled.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, and the worst thing they say is, hey, which normally the doctor says, who are you with? Whether it be CVS, Walgreens, or something.
Where should I send this to?
So yeah. I'm confused about this situation. So, doctor gives you a prescription and his secretary in front says, no. How about call your doctor first? Yeah. That sounds like the easy thing to do.
There's usually a patient portal or something like that.
Contact that doctor who you set the appointment with, send him an email, give him a phone call, and ask why this is happening. He might go, well, that's because I shouldn't have done it. You know, but that's a weird situation, dude.
Yeah, it is.
All right, time for one more talk.
And remember, if we don't get to yours, I print them out, and then we'll do them next week. If my company finds where's this one? Jeff, my wife got injured at work in December. We sought out a lawyer, and they said they couldn't take the case because the employer didn't apply for workers' comp appropriately, and it passed the deadline to file. Is there anything that we could do?
Yeah, she could sue the business. If the business doesn't have workers' comp, then you don't have to go through workers' comp. You can sue the business directly.
Okay, and to do that, get in touch with Jeff.
Yeah.
Jeff at When You Need Us.
If they screwed up their workers' comp, then this opens the door to them being sued.
Yeah. Jeff at whenyouneedus.com or #546.
Oh, yeah, we also have our comedy show we do every month. It'll be March 14th at Bonkers Downtown. Go to whenyouneedus.com/events for free tickets.
All right. Jeff Kaufman from Kaufman & Lind, always appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule. Try to assist our listeners with some guidance.
Anytime. I got to get with the promotion department and get one of them shirts.
Well, like I said, the ship may have sailed on these.
I think they need to redo them then.
That's like a workers' comp claim that, you know, 7 years or so. This shirt's kind of the dead zone.
Look at our boy here. Retaining.
Look at him learning. He's such a good boy.
Picking up what you're putting down.
The lady.
Only took 9 years.
Taco on demand. Download the iHeartRadio app.